This video will explain Rule 1, Application, of the Collision Regulations in detail. Our videos are short and simple to learn, they are good for beginners and best for revision. Most importantly, they cover all the key points. One can revise all the rules in a very short time. Watching and listening is better than reading. Welcome to NSA Marine. Application. Paragraph A. These rules shall apply to all vessels upon the high seas and in all waters connected therewith navigable by seagoing vessels. Paragraph A defines the applicability that these rules shall apply to all vessels. You will learn the definition of vessel in Rule 3. High seas means open seas, coastal waters or waters far away from land. Key highlights of Paragraph A. These rules shall apply to all vessels. High seas, navigable by seagoing vessels. These rules apply to all vessels navigating in all waters connected with the high seas and navigable by seagoing vessels. However, there are certain exemptions given by paragraph B of this rule. Paragraph B. Nothing in these rules shall interfere with the operation of special rules made by an appropriate authority for roadsteads, harbors, rivers, lakes or inland waterways connected with the high seas and navigable by seagoing vessels. Such special rules shall conform as closely as possible to these rules. Paragraph B allows special rules to be made by an appropriate authority for specific areas, and such rules, if made, shall remain restricted only to the defined areas stated in this paragraph. Roadsteads, harbors, rivers, or inland waterways. The requirement that such special rules shall conform as closely as possible to these rules is to eliminate major differences between any special rules and these rules to bring about consistency between them, which would minimize confusion. Definition of roadstead: a place less enclosed than a harbor where ships may ride at anchor. Key highlights of paragraph B. Special rules made by an appropriate authority. Roadsteads, harbors, rivers, lakes or inland waterways. Such special rules shall conform as closely as possible to these rules. Paragraph C. Nothing in these rules shall interfere with the operation of any special rules made by the government of any state with respect to additional station or signal lights, shapes or whistle signals for ships of war, and vessels proceeding under convoy. Or with respect to additional station or signal lights or shapes for fishing vessels engaged in fishing as a fleet. These additional station or signal lights, shapes or whistle signals shall, so far as possible, be such that they cannot be mistaken for any light, shape or signal authorized elsewhere under these rules. Paragraph C and E contain details of special requirements that may be applied as per the defined criteria. There's a little difference in requirements stated in C and E, which sometimes gets confusing. Paragraph C covers two aspects. 1. Additional station or signal lights, shapes or whistle signals but restricted to ships of war or vessels proceeding under convoy. 2. For fishing vessels engaged in fishing as a fleet, the points are similar but with a slightly lowered extent of application, the whistle signals clause is absent. The additional provisions cannot be applied to a single fishing vessel operating alone or independently and not forming part of a fleet. The provisions stated and required by all other rules or requirements stated in these rules shall not interfere with the operation of these special rules. The government of any state has the authority of making any such special rules. C. Further states that the characteristics of these additional station or signal lights, shapes or whistle signals shall, so far as possible, be such that they cannot be mistaken for any light, shape or signal authorized elsewhere under these rules. In other words, these additional systems should be designed to be distinctly different from these rules, to ensure there is no confusion in identification and that the additional requirements are not mixed up with the normal requirements of these rules. Paragraph D. Traffic separation schemes may be adopted by the organization for the purpose of these rules. D. Clarifies that IMO only has the authority to adopt traffic separation schemes. Rule 10 explains traffic separation schemes in detail. whenever the government concerned shall have determined that a vessel of special construction or purpose cannot comply fully with the provisions of any of these rules with respect to the number, position, range or arc of visibility of lights or shapes, as well as to the disposition and characteristics of sound signaling appliances, such vessel shall comply with such other provisions in regard to the number, position, range or arc of visibility of lights or shapes, as well as to the disposition and characteristics of sound signaling appliances, as her government shall have determined to be the closest possible compliance with these rules in respect of that vessel. Paragraph E. Applies to a vessel of special construction or purpose which is unable to comply with the provision of these rules for any reason as may be determined by the government of the flag state concerned with respect to the number, position, range or arc of visibility of lights or shapes, as well as to the disposition and characteristics of sound signaling appliances. The government concerned can then approve alternate provisions in all these aspects. But here the rule states, as her government shall have determined to be the closest possible compliance with these rules in respect of that vessel. Examples of a vessel of special construction or purpose include aircraft carriers. Their side lights may be on the sides of the small superstructure which itself is situated on one side to allow for the large flight deck. Other examples include submarines. Hovercrafts operating on an air cushion are required to be fitted with an additional all-round flashing yellow light as per Rule 23 due to their high operating speeds. Requirements developed under Paragraph C should have features which cannot be mistaken for any light, shape or signal authorized elsewhere under these rules, and these are additional to the requirements stated in these rules, whereas the requirements developed to meet Paragraph E are in lieu of the requirements of these rules or are alternate substitutes because the vessel concerned cannot comply with the prescribed standard.